Welcome back to Swiss Home Garden, Chitra here. In this video, I will be showing you how to use an electric grain mill.
The shape of the mill, as the name suggests itself, is an octagon shape. This mill is very compact and fits well into the corner of my kitchen counter. The mill is made with steamed beech wood and polished with natural linseed oil. This size is ideal for a family of four. For larger families, I would suggest getting octagon 2. The height of this mill is 38.5 cm and the depth and the width is 20 cm. The grinding stones which are housed here are 10 cm in diameter and they are made of corundum ceramic. To grind the flour, you will be feeding the grains on top here. Then the grains are ground in between these stones and the flour comes out of this opening. The weight of the mill is approximately 8.8 kilograms. The motor output is 360 watts. This mill is available in both 230 voltage and 110 voltage. Price of the mill here in Germany is 400 euros and in the US is 440 euros. I will leave a link below in the description box. The height allowance for a bowl to collect the flour is 16 centimeters. The manufacturer Hawos gives a 10-year warranty on this mill. Now let's look into the grinding capacity of wheat. These markings here give an indication of the distance between the grinding stones. When you set it here, for example, to 1, the grinding stones will have very little gap for the grains to pass through. So the grains here can be ground from very fine to very coarse consistency. When you set it to 1, you will get the finest flour, but this also takes longer time to grind. When you increase the marking, you can get a coarser flour and then it's also faster to grind. The grinding capacity of wheat when you have a finer setting is just about 125 grams per minute and the capacity of wheat when you grind at a coarser setting, say for example 4 or 5, you can grind up to 250 to 300 grams per minute. This is the data from the manufacturer. I personally have not measured and timed this. This comes with a two-way plug and here you have the on and off button. Now let's start grinding. First, for the finer setting, I will be setting it to 2 before switching on the machine. When the mill is running, you can increase the settings to a higher setting but not the other way around. Please don't reduce the settings while the mill is running. It's best to switch it off and adjust. The recommended setting for Spelt is 2 and not to go below 1.5. Because when you set it to an even more finer setting, the stones will rub against each other and this will destroy the grinding stones. I will be leaving a table for all the different grinding settings in my blog post, so take a look at it. As you see, in this finer setting, the grain does take longer to grind. Now we have here the finely ground flour. Don't expect this to be white and smooth as the store-bought one. This flour is unbleached and has all the bran in it. Next, for the coarser flour, we will be setting the marking to between 3 to 3.5. You see here, the grains are ground at a much faster rate. Now, to end the process.
So, just before it starts making this noise, I switch it off.
So here, we have both the coarsely ground and the finely ground flour. Stay tuned for the second part of the video. I will be giving you full information of benefits of grinding your own flour and a full tutorial on how to bake your bread from freshly ground flour.
I hope you enjoyed watching this video and this was very informative for you in case you're considering buying a grain mill. I will be linking this product below in the description box and you can take a look at it. I will also link similar products below in the description box. I will leave a lot of information regarding the technicalities of grinding the grain, more technical information about this particular mill in my blog post. So kindly take the time to visit my blog at swisshomegarden.com. This is not a sponsored video. I am doing this out of interest and request from my subscribers. If you are new to my channel, kindly subscribe. I post one new video every week on food from scratch, Swiss country living and our gardening experiences. Thank you for stopping by Swiss Home Garden. Until next time, bye bye.